Hello, everyone. You know how frustrating it is when you need to solder something, but your iron is missing or just not up to the task. Today, I'm going to show you an incredible DIY project where I transform something as common as an old spark plug into a surprisingly useful and powerful tool, a portable soldering iron. This might seem impossible, but in just a few minutes, you'll see how I take simple items and give them a brand new purpose. Now, let's look at the heart of our soldering iron, a spark plug. I'm taking an orange insulated wire and carefully stripping a small section from one end. This exposes the copper strands, which are essential for making electrical connections. I'm wrapping the stripped end of the orange wire tightly around the spark plug's terminal. This ensures good electrical contact. I'm secure this connection, making sure there are no loose ends that could interfere with the circuit. Once the wire is wrapped, I'm stripping the remaining end. I split the stripped wire into two parts and twisted them together in preparation for the next connection. Next, I'm threading the wire through the small nut that was originally on the spark plug, ensuring it wraps securely around the terminal as well. This provides a clean and stable connection point. After wrapping, I trim off any excess wire to keep it neat and prevent short circuits. Here I have a small terminal block. I'm using a screwdriver to disassemble it and remove the internal metal connector. This tiny piece is perfect for creating a stable point for our soldering tip. Leave a comment and let me know which country you are watching from. It's great that we can connect and chat from all over the world. I'm then securing this metal connector to the looped wire on the spark plug, again with the screwdriver, ensuring a tight fit. To create a comfortable handle, I'm taking a small section of PVC pipe. I'll drill a hole through it, large enough for the spark plug to fit snugly. This will provide insulation and a grip for using the soldering iron. The spark plug assembly is then inserted into the pipe. Now, the spark plug with its wire assembly fits perfectly into the PVC pipe, creating a comfortable and insulated handle. Next, I'm preparing another wire, stripping the end with my pliers. This wire will provide the power to our soldering tool. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any interesting ideas coming soon. I removed the spark plug from the PVC pipe and connected the wire to the spark plug end. This completes the circuit for the heating element. After fixing the wire, I'm inserting the spark plug with its attached terminal block piece into the pipe, ensuring it's a tight and stable fit. Once the orange wire is through the pipe and connected to the spark plug, I'm stripping the free end of the wire and attaching an alligator clip. This will make it easy to connect to a power source. Next, I'm crafting the core of our new versatile tool, a heated tip. I'm taking a standard AA battery and carefully peeling off its outer plastic casing using a utility knife. The goal here is to extract the carbon rod from the center. After completely removing the shell, I will use a box cutter to cleanly remove the plastic layer on the battery. Then, I carefully remove the metal positive terminal cap from the top of the battery, then pliers to gently pull out the carbon rod. Then I used pliers to separate the aluminum layer on the outside of the battery. Prepare a small plastic box. I use scissors to cut the aluminum shell that has just been separated. I'm taking this small piece of carbon and placing it into a tiny container. I'm pouring a bit of cleaning liquid into the container with the metal fragments. I carefully use tweezers to remove the dipped carbon rod from the cleaning solution. Then, I give it a thorough wipe with a clean tissue to remove any residue and ensure it's completely clean and ready. A clean tip is crucial for effective soldering. To make our carbon rod tip precise and effective, I'm securing it into a drill chuck. Then, using sandpaper pressed against the spinning tip, I'm refining it. This ensures a clean and effective tip for our new tool. I'll remove the carbon rod and insert its unsharpened end securely into the spark plug connector that we previously prepared. I'll secure it tightly with the screwdriver. This is where the heat will be generated, so a firm connection is essential for safety and performance. Now for the grounding wire. I'm taking a blue insulated wire and stripping both ends. I'll then attach alligator clips to both stripped ends. These clips will connect to our power source and the grounding point. I'm preparing our power source, which is a Makita battery pack. I am attaching two washers to the connectors to ensure a secure connection. Now, I connect the red alligator clip from our spark plug assembly to the positive terminal of the battery, and the blue alligator clip to the negative terminal. I place the original threaded bolt and nut on the piece of wood to start testing on our soldering iron. I attached alligator clips to the threaded bolts to complete the circuit. I applied homemade cleaning solution to the solder spot. This simple spark plug has been transformed into a fully functional and portable soldering iron. As the current flows, the metal blades heat up intensely, glowing red hot. This creates a powerful, precision hot cutting tool. Our DIY soldering iron works perfectly. It's working just as it should, ready to tackle any soldering job. As I apply power, you can see it heating up and glowing brightly, capable of performing small-scale welding tasks. It glows bright orange, demonstrating its capability to heat metal effectively for various applications, like marking or even simple welding. After the nut was welded to the threaded bolt, I used a file to clean it up. It's truly amazing what you can create with a few simple items and a bit of ingenuity. Look at that strong, clean joint. This little tool is a game changer for quick fixes. If you found this project as exciting as I did, please give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more creative DIY projects. Your support means the world to me. I'd love to hear your thoughts or if you try making one yourself, so leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.